primary goal for the veteran is kind of built off of our overall mission to help people build healthy and happy lives. And our programs are focused around veterans who are either facing homelessness or are literally homeless.
We're just guys who are just had a, you know, down on our luck, and we just need a little bit of help.
I was homeless, and through the VA, they suggested VOA because they could help veterans.
The big goal is to help our veterans get past those, life has just happened, we've had a crisis, and get them back on their feet and get them stable.
We're trying to provide a home or to get them back into the workforce to help rebuild those healthy and happy lives. And without a home, it's really hard to do that. And without a job, it's really hard to keep a home.
We have so many different programs and services that they have access to that really helps wrap around them to get them to that stability piece. So when we're talking about grant per diem, we have transitional housing. So if you have a veteran that is homeless, single male veteran, then we have the ability to put them into transitional housing before they get into permanent housing.
I had some health problems and that occurred while in the Navy, and I had a, what they call a fusion done. It's going to take about a year for them to see how good it works.
Maybe there's some goals that they need to work on before they're ready for permanent housing. Maybe trying to find affordable housing just isn't there. So GPD is an option for them.
They can stay there for sometimes up to 2 years where they're able to rebuild their lives and get back into permanent housing.
My old apartment, I wasn't able to get in and out of it. There were 17 stairs. So this place is ground level and everything, and a stable environment for me to, until I can find something suitable for my needs.
If you have a veteran household that is either homeless or at risk of homeless, then the Supportive Services for Veteran Families, SSVF for short, is there to really help them work on those goals. That's all housing focused. So it's getting them either into housing or being able to maintain that housing for a long-term perspective. Our Homeless Veteran Reintegration Program, HVRP for short, is there to help them with employment. And so as you can kind of see, I mean, employment's a piece of housing. If you don't have access to the financial pieces, then that housing stability is gonna be really hard.
Sometimes it's helping them write resumes. Maybe it's providing them work clothes, steel-toe boots for certain jobs that require it. Or maybe we're providing training and we're paying for the training so they can start a new career because their body just can't physically do what they traditionally had done before. So we have a lot of leverage to be able to get them back into that workforce. And of course, when you're able to have stable housing, it just lifts you up as a human being and who you are and providing.
They really gave me the tools I needed. They helped me with the housing, helped me with the job search, they helped me with interview clothes, they helped me prepare my resume. They did everything. I mean, they increased my confidence because I was very low being homeless.
I think that's one of the amazing things about VOA is that we've really started to bring on these key programs and services to our veterans to meet that overall goal of sustainability.
We've really tried hard to make ourselves a hub of information and referrals for veterans to where if they're needing hooked up to VA, they're needing case management from them. We know who to call, we know who to hook them up with.
It's really about getting both the VA and our programs at the same table to really wrap around veterans. VA can provide a lot of the clinical case management that our programs just don't provide, while we tend to really know how to work with landlords and get them into affordable housing. And so it's really capitalizing on each of the program's strengths.
There's a lot of veterans out there who really need a helping hand.
Our veterans are very prideful individuals. I've seen so many veterans cross the threshold of our door, and you can tell, like, the struggle is real to ask for help.
They were told and taught to be strong for so long and to not show any kind of weakness or need. And so that translates to civilian life.
The way I always tell our veterans is like, look, you know, you have answered that call of serving our country. You know, this is our chance to pay you back for that service and to help you in your time of need. Like, this is an honor to be able to do that and to help you. That's what we're here for.
We want to provide that place and those relationships where veterans just know that they don't have to carry this by themselves. They don't have to walk through this by themselves.
I'd be out on the streets. I'd be out on the streets right now and coming off a major surgery like that.
Without them, just the VA alone, no. It wouldn't have been enough.
I probably would not be alive right now if it wasn't for this facility. So I am very, very thankful.
That's why we do what we do. It's providing that home for the holidays. It's providing a safe place for our veterans and for their children and for the rest of their families. Like, that's important work. It's hard work. I mean, there are days that it is really, really hard for our staff and for all of our teammates, but it's so worth it when you know that you've made that difference.